Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
A former PTO president tonight stands accused of having a sexual relationship with a middle school student. And tonight, that former PTO leader is in jail. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Gabrielle Komorowski, and tonight for Carol. The investigation is still going, but police say they have evidence of a five-month sexual relationship between a teen and the former PTO president of his school.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local on the story in our Anderson newsroom tonight. Mandy, how did she know the student?
Well, the alleged victim in this case is friends with the suspect's daughter, and that's why police say he was allowed to go over to the suspect's house. But last month, police got a call from that teen's parents.
After a six-week-long investigation, Williamston police say they have enough evidence to charge Jamie Lee Sanders with criminal sexual conduct with a minor under 16. The 33-year-old is accused of having a sexual relationship with a then 14-year-old student of Palmetto Middle School.
It started early this year, around April of this year, and the victim in this case was a friend of the defendant's daughter. And that's how it all started.
In the warrant, it says Sanders had sex with the teen on multiple occasions. It's at her home on Anderson Drive, even in a portable classroom at Palmetto Middle, where Sanders served as PTO president until she resigned in September. School district officials say Sanders was also a substitute at West Pelzer Elementary last school year, but were told she's never been a full-time employee with the district.
Person of this statue in that position, I mean, they are a figurehead. They're a mentor for a lot of young adults. Unfortunately, sometimes they're taken advantage of. And sometimes these people in those positions, they take advantage of that situation for their own personal gain.
Sanders is now on trespass notice on all school properties as police say the investigation continues.
And Ryan Beasley, the attorney for Sanders, told me that his client is a mother of three and has no criminal history. He says Sanders is cooperating with authorities. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
All right, Mandy, thank you very much. A 14-year-old is charged, accused of sexually assaulting an older, mentally disabled boy. Now, very little information is being released at this point, so we don't know where or when the assault happened. But Spartanburg police tell us the two did know each other. The teen is being held at the juvenile detention facility in Columbia.
The sheriff's office tonight has released the 911 call that led deputies to the home of a couple murdered in Greenville County. Earlier this month, you may recall, Gary and Helen Wells were found dead inside their home on Terramont Drive. Investigators have yet to name a suspect in the case, nor have they commented about a possible motive, but deputies do tell us they do not believe the public is in any danger. That 911 call reveals more about possible evidence found here at the scene.
Do you see any kind of weapons or anything lying near them?
There's a knife laying on the floor near the female body in the back room. I don't see any guns. There's bloody footprints.
The coroner says the couple died from multiple sharp force injuries.
A Williamston police officer has very serious injuries after a hit and run. The wreck was on Highway 86, close to Syracuse Drive on Sunday night. Investigators say Officer April Stiegel has a broken right arm, broken left ankle, five fractured ribs, and a broken finger. We're told the suspect, 23-year-old Valtrez Lomax, hit the officer head-on, then left the scene. He was caught shortly after. Lomax faces charges of DUI, possession of a controlled substance, and leaving the scene of an accident.
An accident turned deadly in front of the jockey lot in Anderson County over the weekend. Here is a picture from the scene. This was submitted by one of our U-Local mobile users. The victim was the jockey lot owner's son, and we're told the car was headed south on Highway 29 when it went off the road and hit two pedestrians. 25-year-old Joseph Mitch McClellan was killed. The other pedestrian suffered some minor injuries. The driver, Christopher Martin, is charged tonight with felony DUI and possession of a controlled substance. His bond hearing was held this afternoon, and the judge set his bond at $70,000. Martin is also not allowed to go around the family or onto the jockey lot property. Mitch McClellan is the son of the late Richard Dickey McClellan, the former owner of the jockey lot, who actually died of cancer in June. And Mitch's stepbrother, Matthew McClellan, was killed in a wreck on September 7th.
The coroner tells us a Clemson University student died in a car wreck over the weekend. It happened yesterday on Hunt Road in Oconee County. Troopers say 20-year-old Coley Hunt pulled into the path of another car as she left her home. The impact of that collision sent her car into the westbound lane where it was hit a second time. Investigators say she died at the scene.
Quite a mystery here. Authorities tell us someone set some mailboxes on fire in Asheville, and they're asking for you to help find who did it if you can. We're told at least six fires were set on October 17th between 6 and 7:30 in the morning. Some of the mailboxes were on Cox Avenue near the post office there, another two in the 81 block of Patton Avenue, one near Wells Fargo Bank, one at the intersection of Haywood Street and Battery Park, and finally, one off Wall Street there in downtown Asheville near the Laughing Seed Restaurant. If you saw anything last Wednesday morning that may have catched this culprit, call Crime Stoppers there in Western North Carolina. The number is 1-888-285-5050.
Commitment 2012 now. Bankers from all over the East Coast were in Asheville today at the Grove Park Inn talking not banking but politics. They listened to the candidates for governor of North Carolina, and News 4's Nigel Robertson was there.
A great deal. Lieutenant Governor Walter Dalton, a Democrat, and former Charlotte Mayor Pat McCrory, a Republican, talked to the North Carolina Bankers Association about why they want to be the state's next chief executive. But remember, early voting is already underway here in North Carolina. That means for these candidates, getting the message out is even more vital. For Dalton, the big issue was education. North Carolina has one of the highest unemployment rates in the nation, and he says making sure everyone has access to education is key.
North Carolina has the best community college system, best university system in the nation. We can build to that future if you don't unduly damage it, but 17% cuts to the university system, I think, unduly damages that.
McCrory's big issue is lowering taxes.
It's high because, first of all, we have one of the highest tax systems in the Southeast. We have regulations that are implemented in such a way that is very non-friendly to our business community.
Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4, Asheville.
Again, early voting is underway in North Carolina. South Carolina does not have early voting, but you can vote absentee if you have a reason why you might not be able to vote on Election Day. And candidates in Greenville County are speaking in a forum right now. The League of Women Voters are holding a forum at the University Center Auditorium in McAllister Square. More than a dozen candidates are set to speak. The forum ends at 8 o'clock tonight. And a quick reminder, tonight is the third and final debate between President Obama and Mitt Romney. The two will shake hands at 9 tonight in Boca Raton, Florida. Foreign policy is expected to be the main topic of discussion, and you can watch it live right here on WYFF 4 tonight at 9. The city of Spartanburg is getting a new website for the first time in some 10 years.
News 4's Mike McCormick tonight gives us a look.
Your website is your welcome center. It's your front porch.
From first impressions to a source for citizens, cityofspartanburg.org is Spartanburg's top tool when it comes to reaching the public.
There's been, you know, a monumental shift in the way people use websites and what they, quite frankly, expect to see.
To adapt to that shift, the city is unveiling a new site. Same address, different design. Here it is, put together by Slant Media, which has offices in Greenville and Charleston, and a co-founder who's a Spartanburg native.
People have been really frustrated with our site in the past.
Compare the two sites. To navigate the old one, you had to know which department you wanted. With the new one, it's broken down by who you are and what you need. There are now sections. I'm a citizen, I'm a business, I'm a visitor, I just need info. Plus, there's an event calendar right on the homepage. Need to report a pothole, pay a fee, or contact a city leader directly? You can do it all here.
We hope that we get a lot of interaction on the website and that people take advantage of the opportunity we're giving them to not only participate in the discussion about their city, but drive the discussion about their city.
The city paid about $50,000 for its new modern interactive online image.
When you look at what you're getting for this website, you know, we think it's money well spent.
The site goes live Tuesday morning. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, Spartanburg.